The personal touch. That's what I'm after. I want photos of her. Lots of them where she eats, sleeps, plays. Oh, especially where she sleeps. I believe the cells are rather cramped.
No, actually, they're quite spacious, and we call them dormitories.
You may call them dormitories, Mrs. Reynolds. I call them cells. I have to keep the public happy.
All right, but I don't think the department will like
Well, if the truth is, if they see an expatriate American living in the lap of luxury, they're going to wonder where their tax money is going to. But if they see a grandmother standing by the bars of a cell with tears in her eyes. Come in!
In.
Oh, Mrs. Reynolds Bryant's outside.
Oh, well, if she wants to see me, I'll...
No, no, I sent for her. Come in. Mrs. Bryant.
I am Miss...
Krantz.
Huh? Oh, no, I'm not Mrs. Bryant, I'm Miss Bryant.
Oh, well, that's a bit of a no-no.
Huh?
Oh, well, never mind, we'll jump that hurdle when we get to it. Now, you come over here and sit down.
Oh, hello, Hazel.
And hi, Samantha. The envelopes for the community chest drive.
Thank you, but I thought you were going to mail them.
Well, I decided to drive by and save the postage.
What? How's Darren? Fine. No, I mean his ears. Oh, you saw them? Him? Well, I ran into him at the Berkeley Hotel, and we started talking, and, well, suddenly they started to sort of bloom.
What were you and he talking about?
Well, he was with this person, and I asked him who this person was, and he told me, and his ears blew up.
Was it a man or a woman?
Who?
This person.
Oh, oh well, I really didn't notice.
Oh, come on, Hazel.
Very well, Samantha. But remember, I didn't volunteer the information.